has an interest in the crowd of the support it provides from a wide array of causes. The recipient receives a medal and a $1,000 contribution to the charity of their choice. Let me introduce to you Suzanne Hilbert, Vice President of Sales of Duval Digital Solutions, to make the presentation. Suzanne, please come to the podium.
So many incredible things that I can tell you about Michael Tagal, but I'll try to keep it brief. It's been 23 years of having the amazing experience of working with Silver Circles. In the early years, getting to know him, we would talk about plans for the weekend, and unlike any 23-year-old that I knew, he would tell me how he would be going to work with Habitat for Humanity. He would then go on to explain in his signature jovial way stories of how he would go into homes with people that were alone and needed help. He would bring them food, clean their apartments, and whatever else he could do to help. At the time, I remember thinking to myself how selfless and inspiring he was. It was just a glimpse of the great things to come. His loyalty to his staff and clients, the deep sense of responsibility and pride that he has shown to all of us, is nothing short of remarkable. All you have to do is look around at his company and see the admiration and respect that everyone has for their fearless leader. What he has done with Tagal Digital Solutions is nothing short of amazing. He took a small, flawed community and led it way beyond what anyone thought it could be. His vision, determination, strength, confidence, leadership, perseverance, and faith brought our company to be one of the greatest graphics companies in the world. I could not be more proud of him. Through every challenge, I have watched him roll up his sleeves and say, yes, we can. When Hurricane Sandy brought devastating flooding to our Brooklyn Navy Yard facilities, he led his team to make the impossible possible. We did not have one late shipment. Mike has an outstanding record of support for community service and charitable causes, from the American Cancer Society and St. Jude's Children's Hospital to Habitat for Humanity and the Make-A-Wish Foundation. He expanded his philanthropic efforts by founding Tagal Big Picture, a nonprofit corporation dedicated to serving communities at the local level. It conducts more than 20 charitable initiatives each year, such as providing computer and software for a Newark, New Jersey youth program and helping Heart Gallery New York City adoption efforts. He is also committed to supporting military veterans and their families through his support of the VA hospital. In addition, he is a volunteer in many industry boards and active with his church, having served as a deacon and leader. And through it all, Mike has maintained who he has always been, a humble, sweet, loyal man with an integrity and strength of character that is seldom seen, especially in such a successful person. It is my great honor to present the Community Service Medal to my dear friend, Michael Tagal.
Certainly removed that one of these schemes. Wow, thank you for that warm reception, and thank you, Suzanne, for that kind introduction. It is an honor and privilege to receive this award for service to both the industry and the community. It's a particular honor because our industry does so much for the communities around us. I love this industry. It's in my blood. I think both literally and figuratively. At this point, it must be at least 3% salt and ink, maybe 5% photochemistry, and as a printer for 23 years, 20% coffee at this point. One thing for sure, being in the printing industry is never boring. Not easy, but never boring. It reminds me of a sign I saw a couple weeks ago that said, "You can't please everyone. You're not big enough." And big money. Yes to the vegans and audience, that good. But as an industry, we really do our part in helping our local communities. I'm really proud of that. We do it in ways like donating money or printing to local schools, churches, and synagogues, and deserving charities and organizations. Maybe even a deserving organization like, say, the PIA. Right, Twister for saying that. But seriously, right? You know, I think that we can make a lot happen by when we do big things, we can donate to causes. I think what you really make the most impact is not just giving our money, but giving of our time and our talents. My pastor once said something that I thought was really profound. He said, I used to complain about the interruptions to my work, and I realized the interruptions were my work. Taking time to be with an employee in crisis, or a friend, giving someone a second or a third chance, even if maybe they don't deserve it, because you see potential in them. Being with people not just in the mountaintop moments, but when they're in the valley. One thing that has helped me in my life, I think, is that I've been both first and I've been worst. And I never forgot what both of those things felt like. And I've used that to drive me and help me and be there for people at different times in their lives. I have a lot of success in business, and some failures too. But nothing ever has felt as good or as rewarding as when you make a difference in someone else's life, whether through work, church, or volunteering. I would give you examples, but I don't want to make you or I cry, nor put more importance on me than I deserve. But rather, just let you know from one imperfect person to another that it's not trite to say it's better to give than receive. I learned a lot over the years from many of the people in this room, particularly from the guests I have seated with me and the family I have with me tonight. Things I'm being recognized for today are in many cases seeds planted by you. Thank you for being part of my life and all you've done for me. I want to close with one last thing to impart to you. Two things my grandfather used to say to me over and over as a child. He would first say, a long and prosperous life. And I know what you're thinking. You ripped that one off from Mr. Spock. But my grandfather was from a small village in India, so I don't think he'd ever heard of Star Trek, so I think I'm going to give it as a Papaji original. But the second thing he would say, which was really important, it stuck with me. He'd say it over and over again. He'd say, be good, do good. Be good, do good. You really can't have one without the other. I just want to encourage you all to find those ways, big and small, that you can be a small light to this world. Thank you again for this honor. Have a wonderful morning. And God bless you.